Now we'll take a look at some examples of solving absolute value equations. Our first equation is the absolute value of x is equal to positive 4. Remember, the absolute value of a number is a number's distance from 0. So another way of thinking about this equation here would be to find the numbers that have a distance from 0 that is equal to 4 units. Well, here's 0 on the number line, so positive 4 would be 4 units from 0. But notice that negative 4 would also be 4 units from 0. Because when we talk about distance, distance is always positive. So this equation has two solutions, x equals negative 4 or x equals positive 4. Looking at our second example, where we have the absolute value of x plus 4 is equal to 12, if we think about the numbers that have an absolute value of 12, we know that positive 12 has an absolute value of 12, but the absolute value of negative 12 is also equal to 12. So what we're going to do is take the expression inside the absolute value of x plus 4, set it equal to positive 12 for one equation, and then set it equal to negative 12 for the second equation. So we'd have x plus 4 equals 12, or x plus 4 equals negative 12. So here we'll subtract 4 on both sides. Here we have x equals 8, or on the right side here we'll subtract 4 again, but now we have x equals negative 16. So notice both of these absolute value equations have two solutions. So notice these absolute value equations have two solutions. So in general, when solving an absolute value equation, the first step will be to isolate the absolute value on one side of the equation. This was already done for us in these two problems. And then we're going to set up and solve two equations based upon the absolute value principle, which we discussed here. And then we should go back and check our answers. So if we wanted to check this second example here, if x is equal to positive 8, notice how positive 8 times 4 is positive 12. The absolute value of 12 is 12. And then when x is negative 16, we'd have the absolute value of negative 16 plus 4, which is negative 12. And the absolute value of negative 12 is still 12. We'll take a look at some more examples in the next video.